So let's first start for the bound states. And in bound states, I consider the very first, the first is the negative side of x. This is the negative side of x, and this is equal to x less than 0 here, and this is the positive side of x, so x greater than 0. I will leave this portion for a while. First, I will see here and see here that what the Schrödinger equation is telling us. So for x less than 0, I know that the delta function is 0 there. So v of x is equal to 0, and the Schrödinger wave equation will become minus h bar square over 2m and d square psi over dx square is equal to e psi. Now this I can further write is d square psi over dx square is equal minus 2me over h bar squared. So, and this is psi as well. Now I know that for I am considering bound state, and for bound state I will consider this e to be negative. So I consider k, and k is such that this is minus 2me square root over h bar. This h bar is out of the square root. Now as e is negative, so minus minus will automatically cancel, and I will say that k is real and positive. So the negative sign is actually accommodated here in e, and we are having d square psi over dx square is equal to k square psi. So now this equation we have solved many times, and I will write this in exponential. So psi of x is equal to a e to the power plus kx and b e to the power minus kx. Now it's a second order differential equation, so we are having two solutions for it, and we will check that which of the solution is important or is good for according to our geometry and which solution is not. Now our geometry is saying us that when x goes to minus infinity, means I am considering this side, when x goes to minus infinity, then my wave function should go to 0. When x is going to minus infinity, when I write x minus infinity, then I see that my wave function is going 0 with this one, means it will be a decaying one. But this one, when x is minus infinity, it will become plus, and this one is growing. This is growing like this and like this, while this one will be decaying like this. So I will consider this solution because this one is wrong. My wave function shouldn't grow at infinity, going to infinity. This one is right. So I say the psi of x is equal to a e to the power kx is the solution. And this will be the wave function that I will have. Similarly, when I consider the second side, now the second side here is x greater than 0. X greater than 0. And when x is greater than 0, I am having the potential again equal to 0 on this side as well. So I will have the Schrödinger wave equation again, minus h bar square over 2m d square psi over dx square, and this will be equal to E psi. Now again the same thing I will do, that this will go here and then I will suppose k equal minus 2 mh bar square, and this k will be real and positive because the E is less than 0, negative for the bound state. So I will have the solution of my wave function is sine of x, and this will be equal to, let's say, f e and kx plus g e minus kx. I have just changed the constants, is they will be different, they may be different, and this is e kx, and this again second order differential equation, two solution, which of the solution is good for us and which is not. If I look at this one, that when I'm on this side, my wave function should decay when I go x to infinity. So this one is decaying while this one is growing. So I will not consider this solution because it is wrong. While this one is, means the wave function, when x is going to infinity, the wave function is going to zero. So I will say that the solution sine of x is equal to g e to the power minus kx. So I will have the wave function equal to g e to the power minus kx. So for our wave function, we got two solutions, and the two solutions are for x less than 0, means when x was negative, we got our solution is sine of x is equal to a e to the power kx, while when for x greater than 0, means when x was positive, our wave function solution was sine x equal g e to the power minus kx. So now we will have to apply the boundary conditions, and the two boundary conditions, very familiar boundary condition, we say that on both sides of the barrier, means of this potential, psi is when is the change or the variation in psi will be the same, means psi will be on the other side of the potential will be the same when it will come to the other side of potential. We say that psi will be continuous. Not only psi will be continuous, but also its variation will be also free from any discontinuity. It will also be continuous. So we will have to apply these boundary conditions. The very first one here, the very first, we will say that psi is always continuous, means psi will have now discontinuity on both sides of the boundaries. And second, we say that d psi over dx, means the variation in this psi is also continuous, means there is no break in it. And this is also continuous except where potential is infinite. So on both sides of this potential, it will also be continuous. So the number one actually gives us that psi at x minus side and the side at x plus side will be equal to 0. So put x equal to 0 there, then we will have that from that equation when psi is continuous. So psi at 0 will be equal to psi at 0 on the other side. Means this is for the x less than 0 side and this is for the x greater than 0 side. So what both of this imply that a e to the power 0, so it will become a, and g e to the power 0 will become g. So this implies that a is equal to g, and our wave function means the two constants become actually equal. So our wave function psi of x will come out to be a e to the power kx and psi of x will be equal to a e to the power minus kx. This will be for x less than 0 side and this will be for x greater than 0 side, means x positive and negative. I will write the equality symbol here as well, because the potential is so thin that I can consider the two solutions to be continuous on both sides. Okay, now what is actually the value of A? So the value of A, to find out this value, I will have to normalize. I will have to normalize the wave function, the psi of x. So in order to normalize this one, let's say we write that from minus infinity to plus infinity, psi mod square dx is equal to 1. This implies for our wave function, we will write that for any of this, that psi equals a e to the power kx and psi e to the power minus kx. So let me take the e to the power minus kx here, as both the constants are the same. So I will write this will become a square, and then integral from minus infinity to plus infinity, the conjugate is no iota is involved, so it will be simple square. So minus k, it will become 2kx. So minus 2kx and dx. Now here this will imply that a squared, and as this is an even function, minus infinity to plus infinity can be replaced by 0 to infinity but 2 times, and e to the power minus 2kx dx, and this is equal to, now what will be the integration of this one? It will be e minus 2kx divided by minus 2k. Now it's simple integral. The e to the power x in 0 to infinity, it will go to 1, while 2k will come here. The minus will cancel, and we will have the simplification of 2 with 2, and this is equal to 1. So this implies a square, and only 1 over k will remain here, 1 over k will remain here, and equal to 1, and this implies that a is equal to square root of k. So our constant we have determined, our psi of x for x less than or equal to 0 is equal to k e to the power, we are having k e to the power kx, and psi of x for x less than greater or equal to 0 is equal to k e to the power minus kx. So this is the our wave function. Now I can plot this wave function is that if I write like this, and this is our x-axis and this is our psi of x. Now our psi of x for x less than 0 is actually a growing function. So it starts here and it grows like this. While our for x greater or equal to 0, it's a decaying function. So it decays like this. So we are having our wave function. This value, the maximum value, when x is equal to 0, then it is equal to k square root. So this maximum value is k square root. It is a decaying function, and this function is e to the power minus kx, while this function is e to the power plus kx. And this will be the plot of our wave functions. Now what about the second condition? The second condition is that d psi over dx is continuous.